We all know that the email is the most widely used formal communication method today. Most of us will at least write one email every day. We should be very careful with the choice of words and phrases while drafting an email. If you don't do so, then not only will you project yourself as unprofessional, you may even portray yourself as rude and impolite, which can undermine your credibility. Today, we shall see an easy trick to make your emails more effective by looking at 6 most commonly used phrases you must avoid in an email. So why wait? Let's get started. Hi, welcome to my new video series Unnati. This is Balu here from SP Tech Bangalore. Let me walk you through 6 common email phrases which you must avoid. Avoid using the phrase "the problem is." This will set a negative tone to the email. Also, even if there is a problem at hand, don't project it as a problem, because the moment you project it as a problem, you will make it sound as if there is no solution. This might cause the reader to panic. So what can you write instead? Avoid usage of the word problem. Try to portray a solution. Okay, let me give you an example. Consider the phrase, "We are facing an issue, but the team is working on it." This sounds much better than using the problem, isn't it? Avoid using the phrase "I think." It's recommended that you need to avoid using the phrase "I think" in all your emails at any cost. The reason being, it indicates uncertainty and shows that you are not confident enough, or you are not completely aware of a given situation. It will do nothing more than rather to set a negative impression about you. Nobody wants it. What can you write instead? Use an assertive sentence. Okay, let me give you an example. "I will learn the details and get back to you with the best solution." Oh, this sounds great. Do you agree? Try it out. Avoid using the phrase "as I mentioned before." One big reason to avoid this phrase is it makes the reader feel that you are undermining his attention to have read and understood your earlier email. This can make the reader demotivated. You don't want to do that, right? What you must understand is the people go through multiple emails every day. And so if you indeed have to explain a point again, be patient. What can you do instead? The right approach is to attempt to provide the details to the reader for the second time. If the person is still not able to follow, then it is recommended that you get in touch with him directly over the phone or meet him personally if possible to give clarity. Using an email with the phrase "as I mentioned before" would really be harsh from your end. Please, please avoid it. Avoid using the phrase "don't hesitate to contact me." Just can't understand why people use this phrase. It is often used especially during closing lines of the email. Why assume the other person will hesitate to contact you? When you yourself have provided your contact details in the email, that itself indicates that they can get in touch with you. So, where is the question of hesitation? What can you write instead? Just mention "get in touch with me," or you can simply write "have a query or suggestion, contact me." But remember to add these phrases before mentioning your contact details. Avoid using these phrases "kindly revert back" or "I will revert back to you shortly." These phrases is one of the most popular and commonly used phrases in business emails. Even I was using this quite often, till I realized that the meaning of the word "revert" and "back" are almost the same. So the insertion of the word "back" in the sentence "kindly revert back" is incorrect. What can you write instead? The correct way would be to write "I will revert to you shortly. This makes sense. I hope you'll buy my argument." Avoid using the phrase "please find the attachment." The phrase is absolutely unnecessary. Once you have attached the file correctly, it will certainly show up in the reader's email box. Why do you want the reader to find it? Sounds crazy. What can you write instead? Keep it simple, guys. The requested document is attached to this email. That's enough. Why complicate things? Avoiding these common phrases in your email will make you sound more professional and polite. You should note that written communication is more prone to misunderstandings, as the other person will have some difficulty to read your expression or decipher your tone of voice. Hence, the approach to writing good emails is to be as clear as possible and remove all signs of ambiguity. Hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for your time. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Press on the notification icon. By doing so, you'll be notified on every new video I release under the Unnati series. So happy emailing. See you in my next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.